Hello everyone, today I am going to explain about the effective nuclear charge and screening constant by using the Slater rule. So which is a very important topic. So 2 or 3 questions will come in the competition examinations, different competitions examination. If you are watching the my videos first time, please watch that till the end, then only you will get the good informations. Like, share and comment the my video. So coming to the topic, effective nuclear charge. Effective nuclear charge, the symbol of effective nuclear charge is Z star is equal Z minus sigma. Here sigma is screening constant. Sigma is equal to screening constant. Z is nothing but nuclear charge. So if you want to know the effective nuclear charge, you have to do all this. This effective nuclear charge is originated from the shielding effect. It is originated. Generally, what is meant by shielding effect? Is the nucleus differentials are present. So this is the outermost shell. General we will call as a N shell. This is called as a nucleus. So nucleus is attracting the electrons present in the valence shell towards itself. Itself attraction electron. So here electrons are present, here also electrons are present. So what will happen? Every electron having the negative charge. So the electron present in the valence shell attracted by the nucleus, generally is called as a nuclear force of attraction. But what will happen? The inner electrons repel with the electron present in the valence shell. That means here the electrons are present. Here also valence shell also electrons are present. Whenever they are repelling with each other, automatically the radius of the atom is increasing. So whenever the radius of the atom is increasing, the nuclear charge is decreasing. So this is called as the effective nuclear charge. Now we have to calculate the effective nuclear charge. Effective nuclear charge, how can you calculate? Original nuclear charge, screening constant. What is mean screening constant? How much repulsion is happened? That's we are calculating. Sigma is stand for the repulsion of the electron. How much it is showing the repulsion of the electrons. Some empirical formulas are proposed by the scientist. Name is called as a Slater. Generally we are called as a Slater rules we are calling. So Slater is the scientist who proposed to calculate the repulsion between the repulsion of the inner electrons. So he proposed that, he said that some rules. First, write the electronic configuration of the element in this order. Like this order we have to write. For example, 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 3d, 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f, and so on, etc. The first step is, if you want to calculate the screening constant or effective nuclear screening constant, we have to write the electronic configuration. Next one, what is the second rule? For example, I am taking the To explain the second rule, I am taking one example, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s1. Here is the electronic configuration. So my electronic configuration is there. See here. So these electrons, these are, for example, write ns, np. I am writing instead of. So electrons to the right of the ns np will not give any repulsion. These only will give the any repulsion. So if it is not giving the any repulsion, that means here 3s1 is not giving the any repulsion on this 2s2p, so automatically this we will not consider. Here the Slater is saying that the whatever the electrons present in the right side of the NSNP, they will not do nothing for the sigma. That means we have to take as sigma is equal to 0 only, we have to take whatever is there. This is the second rule. And third rule is there. For example, this is the N shell, last shell, N minus 1, N minus 2 shells are present. So whatever the electrons present in the nth shell, whatever the electrons is present in the nth shell, NSNP, they will show the repulsion of each electron, show the repulsion of 0.3 value. That means whatever the electrons is present in the nth shell, showing the repulsion 0.35, and N minus 1 0.85, N minus 2 only 1. So these applicable for only NSNP, only applicable for the NSNP electronic configuration. But all the elements not having the NSNP, some of them are having also, some of them are having 3D, 4D, 5D. What about the NSNP? But what about the ND? What about the NF? ND, NF, what about the NF? So here also, same, 0.35 is common. For example, an element containing the 3D subshell or 4D subshell or 4F subshell, whatever it may be, this is the N, N minus 1, N minus 2, N minus 3. So these values are applicable to NSNP. So N here also is same, N here also is same. So that means what is the value here? 0.35. any element, that means ND, NF electronic configuration, any element containing the D subshell, F subshell, the outer shell electron experiences 0.35 value, you have to write. So whatever is there remaining, this is 1, this will become 1, this will become 1. So whatever the inner electron, so total they will experience the 1 value they will experience. So now we are going to calculate the effective nuclear charge of the some element, we will calculate the. For example, I want to know the potassium 4s1, I want to know the effective nuclear charge of the potassium, I want to know. So first of all, which step we have to write? First of all, we have to write the electronic configuration of the particular element we have to write. So now potassium, I am writing the potassium. Potassium whose atomic number is 19, electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. So here only I am writing 2s2, 2p6, I am writing here 2p8, I am writing next one 3s2, 3p6, I am writing 8, 4s1, I am writing. So here I want to know the effective nuclear, I want to know the effective nuclear charge present on the 1s1, 4s1 electron. S subshell, the electron present in the fourth subshell, how many electron? 1 electron is there. I want to know the effective nuclear charge present in the fourth subshell, I want to know. So now you have to use this formula, Z star is equal to Z minus sigma. But first of all, we have to know the sigma. So how many shells? Total 4 shells are present. So first write like this, N minus 1, this will become N minus 2. So here I want to know the screening constant of the 4s1 electron I want to know. So I want to calculate electron present in the nth shell screening constant. So now what I have to do, we should not consider this. So now whatever the electron present in the nth shell, we should not consider, because we are doing the calculation for this only we are considering, because only one is there, 0, one is there. So now what will become, for example here NH4S2 is there, then you have to consider only one electron, only we have to do. We are going to consider only one electrons. So otherwise you can write like this also, 0, because it is nothing is there. So that's why we make it as a 0, we have to make it as a 0 into 0.35. That's why I didn't consider this one. Next one, n minus 1. How many electrons is there n minus 1? 8 electrons is there in the n minus 1. So 0.85 into 8. N minus 1 done. N minus 2. What is the n minus 2 value? N minus 2 value always 1 only. 1 into how many electrons? 8 plus 2. Whatever is there, whatever is the number of there, so many number of the inner shells are present, but will become only 1. 1 into how many? 10. 0 only. That's why I didn't consider this, because only one electron is there. Already second, as for the second rule. So how many? What is, if you do the calculation, you will get 16.80. You will get 16.80 is the sigma. 16.80 is the sigma. But what is the formula affecting Z? Z star is equal Z minus sigma. What is the Z? Nuclear charge 19, nothing but atomic number. 19 minus 16.80 is equal 2.20. This is the effective nuclear charge. This is effective nuclear charge. Next example, by this method you can easily consider the, we can easily consider the anything, any element you can consider very easily. Nuclear charge we have. First of all, we have to do the screening constant. Next one, I want to know the electron present in the zinc 3D screening 4s electron. The electron present in the 3D subshell, the electron present in the 4s subshell, how much they are experiencing the screening constant. I want to know. First of all, what the formula, write the electronic configuration. We have to write the electronic configuration. Electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 3d10, 4s2. First step is 10. First of all, I want to know the 4s. I'm considering as a 4s. 4s, I want to know the 4s. Now I'm going to explain effective nuclear charge for the 4s one electron present in the 4s subshell. I'm talking about the only one electron present in the 4s subshell. So now write n minus 1, n minus 2. N value is how much? N value is equal to 0.35. into how many electrons? Here 2 electrons is there, but always remember, if you are calculating the screening constant for the 1 electron, so here 2 will become 1. If 1 is there, you should be negligible. That only we have done here. Into 1, n minus 1, total how many? 18 electrons is there. 18 into 0.85 plus how many electrons is there? 10 electrons is there. 10 into 1. So if you do the calculation, you will get the 25.65 will get. Screening constant you will get. So 25.65 is the screening constant. You have to subtract from the nuclear charge. 30, you will get the effective nuclear charge you will get. Now I want to know from this electronic configuration, I don't want to need this one. I want to know the screening effective nuclear charge are present on the 3D subshell, 3D electrons. 3D electron I want to know. So here we should not consider this, because I am going to calculation for the 3D. So now 4s will become 0. That only second rule is said that whatever the electron present in the right side, they will not give any value for the screening constant. So now what happened? 3d10. Again, 3d10 is there. Now I am going to doing the calculation for the only one electron. So 3d10 will become 3d9 will come. Because I am doing that only we have done here. 4s2. So, but we have done the calculation for the 4s1 only we have done. Here also, 3d10, 3d9 we have to do. For example, 3d9 is there, we have to do 3d8. For example, 3d8 is there, we have to do the for the only 7 electron. If 8 electrons is there, 7 is there. If 6 electron is present, 5 electrons only we have to do. So now sigma is equal 0.35 into 4, 9. So now we here it will become n, because we are going to calculation this one now. This become n minus 1. So these are all experiments. Right? Plus whatever we are going to calculate, this will become only 0.35. That only here is it. Only n value become 0.35. Rest whatever the electrons is present. So total 18 electrons is there. 18 into 1. So now we will get 21.15. You will get. This is the sigma. We have to subtract from the atomic nuclear charge. You will get the subtraction. So this is the very easy method. Once try to watch once again, definitely we know. So only one thing is, first write the electronic configuration first, right? So if you want to calculate the last electron, you have to calculate the last electron. For example, here 4s2 is there, you are calculating the one electron. So we have to do, for example, here 4s2 is there, so we have to take the one value is there. For example, here 4s1 only is there, you should not take that value. That is remaining n minus 1 n minus 2. N is equal to 0.35 value, n minus is 0.85, n minus 2 is equal to 1 value. In case of the d subshell, f subshell is present, this is similar 0.35. whatever the rest is there, it will become 1 value. It will become 1 value. So first write the electronic configuration, right? 4s2 jing 4s2 I am going to calculate the 4s2. So 4s2 I am going to electron present on the 4s subshell. So 4s2, but while calculation you take as a only one electron. If even though it is two electron is there, take as a one. So here if you do like this, you will get. So now 3d10, I want to know the 3d10. So now this becomes the last shell. So here it will become the, here it will become the n shell. So total whatever is there here become n minus 1 n minus 2, total will become 1. So 3d is there, just take the whatever the electron present in the 3d multiplied with the 0.35. so inner electron multiply with the 1, you have to multiply with the 1, you have to multiply. So thanks so much for watching my video.